San Diegans are starting to fly out of Lindbergh Field again after months of largely staying away. Good evening, I'm Kimberly Hunt.
And I'm Steve Atkinson. We're looking into the impact that's having outside the airport as part of our rebound initiative. Our ABC 10-ish reporter John Horn explains why one business says it needs the travelers to keep coming to survive.
Air travel out of Lindbergh Field came to a near halt when coronavirus restrictions began in March. The shockwave reverberated well beyond the terminals.
We were very scared. We knew what was going to happen.
Al Cruz's livelihood depends on people flying. His family owns San Diego Park Shuttle and Fly, a long-term parking lot northeast of the runway on Pacific Highway.
We're not a big corporation. We don't have a lot of money to sustain us.
When the outbreak hit, Cruz had to let the lot's 15 employees go.
Shocked. We didn't know what to do.
Looking for any income, he struck a deal with a car rental company to store hundreds of its excess vehicles on his asphalt.
It gave us a certain amount of money, not as much as we wanted. It was better than nothing.
Fast forward to June. The lot reopened with the help of a government PPP loan, and in a sign things are changing, 45 cars from travelers are parked. All 15 workers are back.
They were excited to come back to start again.
Air travel is still way down. Last Thursday through Sunday, an average of 8,679 daily travelers went through Lindbergh Field's TSA checkpoint. That's off about 80% from the same time last year. Still, when coronavirus restrictions were in full effect in April, passenger volumes were down 95%.
If the economy keeps on moving forward, yes, we will. But if it does not, it flattens out like that was 3 months ago, we can't survive on that.
In other words, Cruz wants travelers to use the spaces, not rental car companies. John Horn, ABC 10 News.
A spokesman for the Auto Club says it is seeing a surge in people inquiring about road trips for their summer travels. It will release its projections Thursday. And for more stories about how San Diegans are adapting to this pandemic, visit 10news.com/rebound.